We will be using Google Apps this term to access and submit documents to me as part of this class. One of the main apps that you'll use is Google Classroom, but today I'm going to show you how to access PDF files and annotate them using Google Drive. So in this case, I'm looking at a folder for the January 20th class, and when I open it, there's one PDF file that I have available. And this will look very similar to what you will see using Google Classroom. If I have a window like this that shows me a PDF, I tap on the icon for the PDF, and now I'm looking at the contents of the PDF file using the Google Drive app to show me what's in the document. You would normally be looking at this PDF document by tapping on an icon inside the Google Classroom app. But at this point, the Google Drive and Google Classroom apps would be showing you, they would look exactly the same. They would be showing you exactly the same thing. The problem with using Google Drive or Google Classroom for performing work is that Google Drive and Google Classroom are only useful for looking at files. You can't actually annotate, draw on, or type on, or edit this document inside Google Classroom or Google Apps, Google Drive. So what we need to do is to move this document from what happens when you initially open it. This is being displayed in a Google app. We need to move it by tapping the three vertical dots in the upper right-hand corner of the screen. We want to send a copy to a different app. So when you click on Send a Copy, then you want to choose the Open In button. And this is on an iPad. This may look different on an Android or a Windows device, but you can do exactly the same thing. And my tablet recognizes that I have a number of apps I could open a PDF in. I will permit you to use either Adobe Acrobat to annotate PDFs or Xodo. In this case, I'm going to show you how to use Xodo to annotate this app, or this PDF document. In the upper right-hand corner of this screen, now we're looking at the same consent form PDF using Xodo. You can tap on the pencil icon. That brings up in the top of the screen, again, this banner that contains all of the editing tools. I'm going to touch the paintbrush, and that lets me hand annotate or draw on this document, for example, to add the date, to mark a box, to add my initials, to take notes, if you like. And so this is exactly how I'd like you to deal with this consent form that's part of our Google Classroom assignment for today. When you're done and you're happy with the annotations that you've made, you click the Save in the upper right-hand corner. And now, one little trick. If you touch on one of your annotations, it brings up this field that lets you change the color of the lines you were drawing in, the thickness of the lines, and so forth. You can also delete all of these annotations at this point. I'm happy with what I've done at this point, so I'm not going to do any of that. Now, to get rid of the annotation toolbar at the top of the screen, I click the X on the right, and that brings us back to our normal view, where we can see our signed consent form. Remember, this is now in the Xodo app, and what I want to do is get it back to my Google Classroom so that I can attach it to the Google Classroom assignment and submit it to the instructor. To do that, I'm going to select the open square with the up arrow in the upper right part of the screen. That's send. So again, I can open in. Now I want to open this either in Google Classroom or in Google Drive. In this case, I'm just going to choose Google Drive. It asks if I want to save this file to my Google Drive account. I choose save. One upload complete. And now I have my annotated PDF from Xodo back into my Google Apps. Now you'll notice that the drawings that I made do not show up. This is a flaw with Google Apps. When you have a PDF file that has been annotated in another program, when you open it back in one of the Google Apps, for whatever reason, the Google Apps, be it Drive or Classroom, do not show the annotations. This should not freak you out. It will. But rest assured, the apps or the annotations are still there. So here I am in my Google Drive. Here's my consent form. It doesn't show the annotations. But now that that file is stored on my Google Drive account, when I go back into Google Classroom, I can choose to attach this annotated PDF file to my Google Classroom assignment and submit it.